Last class we were doing, now I'll start, okay? So how are you all, first of all? How are you all?
Fine, ma'am.
Okay, very good, very good. So you all were very good. You were doing your work. You were sending the works to me. Whatever assignment was given, homework was given, you were doing it very good. Keep it up. Now, in the last class, I have done All in the Family, all about the family, isn't it? So you have studied that, isn't it? Now, today, I will do Together in My World, that is chapter 3, which is on page 24. All right? Have you opened the page? Page 24? Together.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, good. Together in My World. So are you all ready? Okay. Now.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, Dipsana Thapa, very good. Most of you are joining. It's very good. All right. Open to page 24. Once again, I'm telling you. And we will do the lesson. That is chapter 3, Together in My World, okay? So last time we had learned about family, all in the family. And what do we do? And who all are there in the family? And how do we help our family? So how many family members are there? And like some of you have big family, some of you have small family, isn't it? Extended family. You had learned all about these. Now, besides these, we have other people in the world. So, we are going to learn. They are neighbors, friends, and other people around us. So, today, in this chapter, we are going to learn about neighbors and friends. All right?
Yes, ma'am.
Can you hear? Okay. All right.
Yes,
so,
ma'am.
First of all, we will discuss about neighbors. We will read about neighbors. Who our neighbors are? Neighbors. The area near and around our house is called our neighborhood. People who stay in our neighborhood are our neighbors. Now look here. The area means the place that is near and around your neighborhood, around your house is called a neighborhood, okay? So where is your house? So beside your house or behind your house or nearby your house or around your house, there are many other houses, isn't it? So who all stay there? They are your neighbors. They are your neighbors. They stay around your house, nearby your house, and they are called your neighbors. I think all of you have neighbors, isn't it? There are houses around your house? Yes or no?
Yes, so, yes, ma'am. Yes.
All of you have neighbors. So, and people who stay in our neighborhood are our neighbors. So the houses that are around and the area is called your neighborhood, okay? And the people who stay there are our neighbors. And Arav is yawning. What happened? Arav, you didn't sleep. You didn't sleep.
Yes, ma'am.
Are you well? Okay. All right. So we celebrate festivals and special occasions together. Good neighbors help each other in times of need. So we work together with our neighbors to make our neighborhood cleaner, greener, and better. Now see, now have you understood what neighborhood is? And the people who stay in the neighborhood are our neighbors, okay? And we celebrate festivals and special occasions. Like festivals, you have studied. What all are festivals now? Durga Puja is a festival. Diwali is a festival. Christmas is a festival. So we celebrate many festivals. we celebrate festivals with our family and also with our neighbors. All right. So not only festivals, special occasions, that is wedding. You know what is wedding? Birthday parties. Are you listening? Birthday parties, weddings, all these are special occasions. So when the neighbors invite you, you go there and like supposing if your friend from your neighborhood, it's his birthday, so you are invited there. You go there, isn't it? So you celebrate the birthday. That is a special occasion, okay? So this way, we celebrate special occasions, we celebrate festivals together with our neighbors also. And another thing, good neighbors help each other in times of need. All right. So when someone is sick in your house, do your neighbors come and visit them? Yes, isn't it? All people come.
Yes, ma'am.
Neighbors come and visit you because this shows that the neighbors are good. Neighbors are good. In the same way, if someone is sick and or otherwise something happens to someone in the neighborhood, you have to go and help them. You have to go and see them. All right. So, and another thing is, whenever someone is in need, we have to help them. When some neighbor is in need, we have to help them. So another thing is, neighborhood is a big area, isn't it? So people will be there. So sometimes it is very dirty. So what you have to do to make the neighborhood clean, all of you should come together and clean the neighborhood. You have to clean the neighborhood. You have to help each other to clean the neighborhood and make it clean. And sometimes you have to plant trees also. Plants, even green plants and trees. Understood? So this way, do you know why we have to plant all these things? Because it gives us oxygen. It makes the air pure. And we need oxygen to breathe. And oxygen is very important. If we don't get oxygen, then people will die. Isn't it? So plants and trees give us oxygen. All right. And another thing, we must greet our neighbors when we meet them. Now, what is this? Greet our neighbors. Do you have any idea? Can anyone tell me? We must greet our neighbors when we meet them. That is, when you are walking outside your house, you will see someone from your neighborhood. And he will see like, good morning, uncle. Good morning, auntie. How are you? What is this? Yeah, greeting, isn't it? You smile and greet them. You talk to them. This is called greeting. Greeting your neighbors. And supposing if you have a friend there, how are you? What are you doing? You'll say that, isn't it? So you talk to them. So it is good. So we should be kind and polite towards them. We should be kind and polite towards our neighbors. We should not fight with them. We should not fight with them. All right. We should be good towards them. And they will also be good towards you. And we should never disturb each other by playing loud music. Everyone wants to listen to music, isn't it? But sometimes in your neighborhood, there are some people who like to listen to loud music. But what happens when you do this? You will be disturbing the other house, the other neighbors, because you have free time and you will be listening to the music, isn't it? Because you have free time, you are just listening. But in someone else's house in your neighborhood, they must be studying. So the loud music will disturb the others, isn't it? And they might be sick, they might be resting, they might be sleeping. So if you play loud music in your house, what happens? The others will be disturbed. Understood? So another thing, when you stay in a neighborhood, you should never play loud music and disturb them. All right. So This is very important. These are the things that you have to keep in mind. Like you have to be kind and polite towards them. You must greet them when you meet. And you should not disturb by playing loud music. All right? Because if you play soft music, then it is soothing. You like to listen also. Loud music is not good. It will disturb your neighborhood as well. So you have to keep all these things in mind. All right. So I hope you have understood about neighbors. Yes or no? And what is a neighborhood? Have
yes,
you understood?
Ma'am.
Yes, really. Only Arav is answering.
Yes, ma'am.
Where are the others? Vicky, are you there?
Yes, ma'am.
Vicky, Aradhya Singh. Who all have joined? Okay. Anyway, now let's do friends. Now, again, the time is going. So let's talk about friends. All right. Friends are important people in our life. It is nice to have friends. We make friends in school and also in our neighborhood. We visit each other during free time or on special occasions. So look here. Friends are important in our life. Friends are important in our life. Why? Why do you think so? When you go to school, okay, I will tell you. When you go to school and if you can make friends, then you will feel happy. And you will not feel lonely, isn't it? You can talk to them. You can play with them. Yes or no? Like, for example, you must be missing your friends because the school is not on. So you must be missing your friends.
Yes, ma'am.
I know that. Yes, it's true. You like to play with them. You like to talk to them. You like to share your things with them, isn't it? But another thing is, it is nice to have friends, and we have friends in school as well as in our neighborhood. I think you have friends in your neighborhood also. Yes? Do you have friends in
yes,
your neighborhood?
Ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Now, at least you can play with your neighborhood children, but at present, because of this pandemic, it is not good to go out and mix with others. Understood? You have to stay safe inside the house. So now you have to stay inside the house, whether you feel bored or anything. It is, but your family members are there, isn't it? So you should be happy. They have time to stay with you. So you should be happy. All right. Then we visit each other during free time or on special occasions. Like that time I told you, whenever you have free time, you go and visit them. You go to their house. They come to your house. And if you have a birthday, you will invite them. And if they have a birthday, then for the birthday party, you are invited. So this way, we go to each other's house, isn't it? We play, talk, and go on picnics and outings with our friends. These activities are all means of recreation. Now look here. Once again, I'm going to repeat. We play, talk, and go on picnics and outings with our friends. So what are all these activities? These activities are all means of recreation. Such activities make us feel refreshed and relaxed. Now, these activities are all means of recreation. Such activities make us feel refreshed and relaxed. Now, what is recreation? Now, recreation is something like, if you have free time, you like to spend that free time doing something else, isn't it? Not working, studying, these are not recreation. But you feel like happy and you want to entertain yourself, isn't it? So for all these, you need recreation, like going out with your friends, going for a picnic, talking to them, watching movie. All these are recreation and playing games, isn't it? So when you do these activities, you feel relaxed and refreshed. You feel happy also, and you enjoy yourself. Yes or no? Okay. So this way, we love playing different games with our friends. You like to play different games with your friends, isn't it? Games are of different types. Like indoor games are games we play inside the house or inside the school. These are indoor games. The games that we play inside the house or inside the school or inside any building is an indoor game. All right. So some of the indoor games are board games. Board games such as Ludo. Have you played Ludo? Ludo. Snakes.
Yes, ma'am.
And snakes and ladders. Carom, Scrabble, and chess are popular indoor games. So board games such as Ludo, snakes, and ladders, Carom, Scrabble, and chess are popular indoor games. All right, so these type of games which can be played indoors are indoor games, that is inside the house. And there are some games which we have to play outside the house, outside the building, in an open area. So the games that are played outside the buildings in open spaces are known as outdoor games. All right. The games that are played outside are called outdoor games. So badminton, cricket, and football are popular outdoor games. Now, badminton, cricket, and football are popular outdoor games. At the same time, there are other outdoor games also. Can you name any? Can you name any other outdoor game which can be played outside?
Basketball.
Okay, basketball, cricket. Yes, cricket is here. Hockey also. Hockey. I think you have heard about hockey, isn't it? Hockey is also an outdoor game. All right. Hockey is also an outdoor game. Badminton is an outdoor game. Football is an outdoor game. Cricket is an outdoor game. So all these are outdoor games. And these games need open spaces, big spaces. All right. So cricket can't be played in a small place. Badminton also. Football. Sometimes if the area is too big inside the building, then you can play badminton, of course. All these things, but these are outdoor games. These games have to be played outside only. All right. So now, do you know the difference between indoor games and outdoor games? Children, I'm asking you, you can.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yes, I'm getting only one answer, like answer from one child only. What about the others? Vicky Elmo, Aradhya Singh. Yes. I can't see you also. I can't see you all. Okay, Dikki, have you understood? Have
yes,
you understood?
Ma'am.
You heard everything. Did you yes, hear ma'am. Everything? Friends, about your friends, did you hear? Okay.
Yes.
So, indoor and outdoor games. I explained indoor and outdoor games. Did you hear
yes.
all these? Okay. And what about Aradhya? Aradhya, I want to see you. Aradhya, please come out. Okay. So look here. All right. Then who else is there? Dipsana. Dipsana, where are you? Dipsana, can you hear me? Dipsana, can you hear me? All right. It's okay. Anyway, so from Together in My World, we have learned about neighbors and friends. So I'll be giving some work to you from here, and you have to learn the spellings as well, okay? So on page 27, so I will show you. Can you all see this, page 27? I think you can't see it clearly, but please look, page 27. What do you have there? What do you have there? Question number one. Have you opened to question number one? Tick the correct answers. Here, A.
Yes, ma'am.
I will just read it out. A. Neighbors live. Neighbors live. Now, there are four options. Number one, nearby each other. Number two, far from each other. Number three, in another city. Number four, in another country. Now, which is the right option? Neighbors live.
Nearby each other.
Very good. Nearby each other. Okay. Neighbors live nearby each other. That is near your house. It means that. Okay. Nearby your house in your neighborhood. Okay. B. Which of these is not an indoor game? Number one, Ludo. Number two, hockey. Number three, carom. Number four, chess. Not an indoor game. Number one, Ludo. Number two, hockey. Number three, carom. And number four, chess. Which is not an indoor game from here?
Hockey.
Yes?
Hockey. Hockey.
Number two, hockey. Very good. H-O-C-K-E-Y. Who answered this? Aradhya. You answered? Who answered this? Hockey. Very good. Okay. C now. Which of these is not a recreational activity? Now, recreational activity. Just think, I had explained to you what is a recreational activity. Now, number one, playing games. Now, not a recreational activity. Not a recreational activity. Playing games, number two, watching television. Number three, studying. Number four, going out on a picnic. Which one is not a recreational activity? Who can say? Playing
studying.
Games, what? Studying, very good.
Watching television.
That is recreational activity. Not a recreational activity. Arav, not a recreational activity. Number three, studying. Okay. All right. Maybe you did not hear. So number three, studying is not a recreational activity. Number three. All right. Now D, look at D. Which of these is not true? Look here. It is all about neighbors. Which of these is not true? I will read four sentences. You have to tell me which sentence is not true. Number one, good neighbors help each other. Number two, good neighbors take care of the neighborhood. Number three, good neighbors fight with one another. And number four, good neighbors greet each other. So which do you think is the right one or true?
Number three.
Very good. Number three is not true. Number three is not true. Good neighbors fight with one another. This is wrong, isn't it? Good neighbors will not fight with one another. So number three is not true. Good neighbors fight with one another. This is not true because good neighbors do not fight. All right. E, look at E. What is true about being friends? Number one, friends are fun. Number two, we love spending time with friends. Number three, we play with friends. Number four, all of these. Now, before answering, you will have to think. What is true about being friends? Number one, friends are fun. Number two, we love spending time with friends. Number three, we play with friends. Come on.
Number four.
All of these.
All
number
the others.
Yeah, number one is also right. Two is right. Three is right. So for this, number four, all of these. Okay. So number four, answer is number four. Now number two, right, true or false? Right, true or false? A. Now you just have to tell me which sentence is true and which is false. A. The area near and around a house is our neighborhood. The area near and around our house is our neighborhood. Is it true or false? The area, the place is true. It is true. Very good. True.
True.
B. Neighbors. Now listen carefully. B. neighbors stay in different neighborhoods. Is this true or false? Neighbors stay in different neighborhoods. Yes?
False.
Okay, see, we must not talk with our neighbors. We must not talk with our neighbors. Is this true or false?
False, yes,
good. Okay, we have to talk to them, isn't it? D, we should help to make the neighborhood green and clean. We should help to make the neighborhood green and clean. True. Is this true or false? True. Very good, Dicky. True. All right, true. And E, we have friends in school and in the neighborhood. We have friends in school and in the neighborhood. Is this true or false?
True.
Is this true? Very good, Ara. Okay. So here, you have to do these two. Number one, tick the correct answers. And number two, write true or false in your copy, any copy, whichever you have, whichever copy you have, do it there. And you can send it through my WhatsApp. Okay. And this answer each of the following in one sentence, like what is a neighborhood? How is having friends fun? And what can we do to help elderly people? So for this, you have to learn. We have to do another part also from here, that is other people around us, which I will be doing in the other class. All right. Then we will do the question answers. So for today, you will do only question number 1 and 2 from page 27. All right. Take the correct answers and write true or false. Okay. Now, do you have anything to ask? Do you have anything to ask me?
Okay, ma'am.
Have you heard?
No, ma'am.
No. Okay, you understood everything. And did you hear everything? Is it clear? Or is it breaking?
Yes.
Is it clear? Yes.
Yes,
you
ma'am.
Can hear everything.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Dipsana, I can't see Dipsana. Dipsana doesn't talk. Where is Dipsana? I want to see you. Dipsana, are you online? Where are you, Dipsana? I can see Dikki, I can see Arav, I can see Aradhya Singh.